हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अ वेरी वार्म गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू एंड वेलकम बैक इन अवर साइंस सेशन। सो एज वी नो, वी आर डिस्कसिंग अवर लेसन दैट इज गेटिंग टू नो प्लांट। इन दिस लेसन ऑलरेडी वी हैव डिस्कस सम पार्ट्स ऑफ अ प्लांट्स एंड नाउ वी हैव रीच टू द लास्ट पॉइंट ऑफ द लेसन, दैट इज टूडे वी विल डिस्कस द फ्लावर, ओके, और द फ्लावर्स। सो लेट डिस्कस अबाउट द फ्लावर्स। फ्लावर्स आर द मोस्ट ब्यूटिफुल पार्ट ऑफ अ प्लांट। डिफरेंट प्लांट्स हैव डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फ्लावर्स। Flowers are of many sizes, shapes and color. So as we know, there are the different plants are there. There are a variety of the plants are there, and that variety of the plants are having the different types of the flowers. They are having the different size, shape and the color. And the main thing about the flower is what? It is the most important or the most beautiful part of a plant. They have different kind of fragrance. Some common flowers are hibiscus, rose, jasmine. So we can say that the flowers are having the different kinds of fragrance. For we can say that if we'll talk about the jasmine and the rose, then these flowers are there which are having very nice, very pleasant fragrance. Okay. Some common flowers are hibiscus, rose, jasmine, sunflower, marigold and lily. Flowers contain the reproductive organ of the plants, okay. And a very important thing about the flower is what? That flower contains the reproductive organs of the plant. So there are the different parts of a plants are there. So let's discuss parts of a flower is there. Let's discuss. The flower is attached to the stem by a stalk called pedicel, okay. So you can see here, this is called as what? Pedicel. This structure is called as what? Pedicel. So with the help of this pedicel, the plants can get attached to the stem. Next one, we can say that the uppermost part of the stalk is somewhat swollen. The swollen part of the pedicel is called thalamus. Okay. So here you can see this is what? Pedicel. And the upper part of the pedicel is little bit swollen. They are thick in the size, and the swollen part of the pedicel, it is called as what? Thalamus. Okay, this portion, it is called as what? Thalamus. Next one, we can say that the other part of a flower are arranged in a ring or whorls on the thalamus. Some flowers do not have pedicel and are called sessile flowers. Okay, so the remaining part of a flowers are arranged in a ring manner on the thalamus. There are the some flowers, those who do not have a pedicel, they are directly attached to the stem, and that type of the flowers are called as sessile flowers. So let's come to know what is given extra things about the flower. Most of the plants bear flowers and are called flowering plants. So obviously the plants which bears the flowers, that plants are called as flowering plants. For example, we can say rose, neem, bougainvillea, mustard, sunflower, all these are the examples of flowering plants. Some plants do not bear the flowers and are called non-flowering plants. But there are the certain plants who doesn't bear the flowers, and that type of the plants are called as non-flowering plants. For example, we can say fern, moss and coniferous like pine are the some examples of non-flowering plants. So the important thing you have to keep in the mind is what? The plants which bears the flowers, they are called flowering plants. The plants which doesn't bears the flower are called as non-flowering plants. So up till now we have discussed about the pedicel, we have discussed about the thalamus, okay. Again I will show you, we have discussed about the pedicel, and again also we have discussed about the thalamus. Now we'll see the next parts of a flower. The main parts of a flower are sepals, petals, stamen and pistil. So first I will show you in the diagram. These are the sepals, these are the petals, these are stamen, and this is what? Pistil. Okay, now I will show you the real flower. See here, I am having this real flower. So this green color portion you can see over here, this is what? Sepals. These are obviously, you know, this is what? Petals. Okay, so now we have discussed about these sepals. These are all are the petals, and now I will show you the next part, that is, see here you can see this, this is what? Stigma. Okay, and here you can see the yellowish color substance. Okay, so this yellowish color substance you can see here, that is nothing but what? Stamen. Okay, it is called as what? Stamen. And this stigma, just now I said, this is the one part of what? Pistil. So these four, two main parts are there. This is what? Stamen. And this is what? Pistil. Okay, the pistil is again having three parts that we are going to see in our next session. So now you can keep in mind the four main parts of a flower, that are sepals, petals, these are stamen, and this is what? Pistil. Okay, this is what? Pistil, we can say that. Okay, so these all parts we will see now deeply one by one. First we'll discuss about the sepals. Okay, so the green leaf like part in the outermost circle of a flower are called sepals. You can see this is the green part, green leaf like part in the outermost circles of a flower are called what? Sepals. And what is the functions of these sepals? So these sepals protects the flowers during their bud stage, and that is the reason in the most of the flower the number of the petals and the number of the sepals are same. Okay, so this is about sepal. Now we'll move for the next one, that is petals. So these are usually the bright color due to the presence of colored pigment. Okay, so the different petals in the different flowers, we can see that, and usually they are having very bright color due to the presence of colorful pigments. The bright color of the petals serves to attract the insect that help in the pollination. Okay, so why the color of the petals are so much bright? Because of that bright color, all the insects are getting attracted towards the flower, and that is very important for the process of pollination. What is the process of pollination? That now we will discuss. Okay, so this is about the sepals and these are about the petals. Now we'll move for the next part of a plant, that is we will discuss about the stamen. Okay, which is very important. Okay, so now here you can see that stamen, this yellow color substance, you can see over it, this is what? Stamen. Okay, these are what? All these are what? Stamens. So they are found just inside the petals. Okay, these stamens are just found inside the petals. They are get covered with the petals. They are usually 4 to 6 in numbers. Okay, they are usually 4 to 6 in numbers. The stamen is the male reproductive part of a flower. Very important sentence, students, keep in the mind is that what? The stamens are the male reproductive organ of a flower. Each stamen contains of a thin star called filament. Okay, so now see here, this is what? Stamen. Okay, here you can see these all are what? Stamen. So now I have separated one stamen from the flower. So see, this stamen consists one thin stalk. Okay, so here you can see this thin stalk is there, and that thin stalk is called as what? Filament. And a two lobed head, it is having the two this one and this one, it is having the two lobed head, and that two lobed head is called as what? Anther. Okay, so the stamens are having two parts, that is what? This is thin stalk, which is called filament, and this two lobed head, which is called as what? Anther. Okay, so this each anther lobed has a two pollen sac. Okay, so now I will show you from the textbook. This is the two anther lobe. These anther lobes are having the two sac like structures, and in that sac like structures there are the pollen grain, or the dust particles are there, dust like particles are there, that we are calling as what? Pollen grain. Okay, so see here what is given. Each anther lobe has two pollen sacs that are filled with pollen grains. Pollen grains are yellow, fine dust-like particles that contain the male sex cell of the flowering plant. Yes, okay. So, the pollen grains are yellow, fine dust-like structures that contains the male sex cell of the flowering plant. So, the pollen grains are the yellow, fine dust-like structure that contain the male sex cell of the flowering plant. This is all about today. The remaining part, and that is very important, that is what? Pistil, that we will see in the next video. And for today, thank you.